Wherever you are, whatever time of day it is, a huge welcome to the Christmas service for Calne. Taking part are St Edmund's Church, the Marden, Vale Anglican team and the Baptist, Methodist and Dayspring churches. 2020 has been hard for most of us and terribly difficult for some. We wait in hope of getting vaccinated sometime next year, returning to a more open, safer existence. But here and now we invite you to celebrate the special timeless hope wrapped up in the birth of Christ. So on behalf of all of us in the Calne Partnership of Churches, I wish you a happy and blessed Christmas and invite you to just sit back and enjoy.
Well, welcome to everyone watching. I'm delighted to introduce the contribution from St. Edmund's Catholic Church in Calne. This is our contribution to the Christmas Advent service. We start by illustrating the Nativity with the Archangel Gabriel's visit to Mary. And I'm going to hand over to Patricia, who's going to do our reading for us.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph, the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. He went in and said to her, "Rejoice, so highly favored. The Lord is with you." She was deeply disturbed by these words and asked herself what this greeting could mean. But the angel said to her, "Mary, do not be afraid. You have won God's favor. Listen, you are to conceive and bear a son, and you must name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor David, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and his reign will have no end." Mary said to the angel, "But how can this come about, since I am a virgin?" "The Holy Spirit will come upon you," the angel answered, "and the power of the Most High will cover you with its shadow. And so the child will be holy and will be called Son of God. Know this too, your kinswoman Elizabeth has in her old age herself conceived a son, and she whom people call barren is now in her sixth month, for nothing is impossible to God." "I am the handmaid of the Lord," said Mary. "Let what you have said be done to me." And the angel left her.
The Lord is with you. For the opportunity with the Calne Partnership of Churches to present the birth of Jesus. We at St. Edmund's are delighted to portray the visit of Archangel Gabriel to Mary to announce that she has been chosen by God to be the mother of his dearly beloved son. Meek and humble Mary has found favour with God in her simplicity and gentleness of spirit. May we too take comfort from this, knowing that we do not have to be strong and powerful to be noticed. As Jesus said, "Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth." May this Christmas we unite with all our brothers and sisters in Calne's churches, praising and thanking you, Almighty God, for your merciful love to us in the wondrous gift of baby Jesus, who will become our loving Saviour. Amen.
Reading from Luke chapter 2, beginning at verse 1, the birth of Jesus. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him, and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. Thanks be to God for his word.
Keep up. the child's mark. About me, Luke and Matthew are silent, and Mark isn't concerned. Even Mary and Joseph are not mentioned by him, and no word of a birth. He begins simply with a voice nourished by locusts, a wild voice in a desert place, repent. John's word, by contrast, is massive. Logos is for philosophers and theologians. Matthew may give rise to Christmas card camels, and Luke to prenatal greetings and a church pop song, but I figure in none of them. I'm not sure how I came to be so popular, but here I am, on a dusty road, with a pregnant girl and her fiancé, seemingly not the father of the child. I am Equus Africanus Asinus. Sounds impressive, but I only do the fetching and carrying in these parts. I suppose that's how I got drawn in, a bit part in a divine plan, an extra in a godly narrative. I do my part. I've been captured on many a Renaissance canvas and been played by numberless children wearing tails. I have many stories to tell, and the stables I visited are beyond counting. But there is no story and no stable that compares to this, where a star directs the company and angels sing to shepherds, proclaiming not only a birth, but a heavenly truth about a child lying in a manger in David's royal city, about a promised Messiah making peace. They say this child too will fetch and carry. They say he will be like a shepherd fetching his sheep from far and frightening places, that he will carry home the lost on his shoulders, that between them would be stretched the suffering of the world, and on his outstretched arms will be pinned the fears and hopes of many people. All I know is that upon my back an unborn child was rested, and from Mary's womb of hope he has made his mark, and that I am his.
Let us pray. When I say the words, "We are waiting, Jesus," please respond with, "Come and live with us soon." Jesus, we are waiting because we know who you are, the creator of the world, the God who took on human form, the son of Mary, a girl just like any other. We are waiting, Jesus. Come and live with us soon. Jesus, we are waiting because we have faith in you. We know that we can trust you. We remember that you are good to us, and we thank you for all the good things that you give to us every day. We are waiting, Jesus. Come and live with us soon. Jesus, we are waiting here, here in Calne and the surrounding villages, waiting for you to come into our houses, our streets, our shops and places of work, to fill them with your light and peace. We are waiting, Jesus. Come and live with us soon. Jesus, we are waiting for you to come and change things, to bring health to our sick ones, to make our asylum seekers welcome, to comfort those who have lost loved ones, and to turn us around, so that we can be your hands and feet your ears and eyes in this world that needs you so much. We are waiting, Jesus. Come and live with us soon. Amen.
The shepherds go to the manger. There were some shepherds in that part of the country who were spending the night in their fields, taking care of their flocks. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone over them. They were terribly afraid, but the angel said to them, "Don't be afraid. I am here with good news for you, which will bring great joy to all the people. This very day, in David's town, your Saviour was born, Christ the Lord. And this is what will prove it to you. You will find a baby wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great army of heaven's angels appeared with the angel, singing praises to God. "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to those with whom he is pleased." When the angels went away from them back into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and saw the baby lying in the manger. When the shepherds saw him, they told them what the angel had said about the child. All who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said. Mary remembered all these things and thought deeply about them. The shepherds went back, singing praises to God for all they had heard and seen. It had been just as the angel had told them.
What love is this that gets upon, becomes so small that we might live such love that takes on human flesh? A manger finds its breath. What love is this that calls the least and beckons them to find a babe from hilltop where they gain their keep, to kneel and worship all they crave? Angels sing of love, come down, a Saviour born.
The story of the wise men found in the Bible in the book of Matthew, chapter 2. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea,
Herod was king. During this time, some wise men from the east came to Jerusalem and said, "Where is the child born to be king of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard about this, he was worried, and so was everyone else in Jerusalem. Herod brought together the chief priests and the teachers of the law of Moses and asked them, "Where will the Messiah be born?" They told him, "He will be born in Bethlehem, just as the prophet wrote, 'Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, you are very important among the towns of Judea. From your town will come a leader who will be like a shepherd for my people Israel.'" Herod secretly called in the wise men and asked them when they had first seen the star. He told them, "Go to Bethlehem and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, let me know. I want to go and worship him too." The wise men listened to what the king had said and then left. And then the star they had seen in the east went on ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. They were thrilled and excited to see the star. When the wise men went into the house and saw the child with Mary, his mother, they knelt down and they worshipped him. They took out their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh and gave them to him. Later, they were warned in a dream not to return to Herod, and so they went back home by another road.
Kings, a Christmas poem by Mark Green. We were not three, and not kings, at least not when we arrived, and really more curious than wise, craning for truth in starlit skies, but at least looking, at least checking what we thought we knew, a king born for the Jews. No, we were not wise, more stupid than wise, asking another king to point us to a rival's cradle, but at least asking and finding truth in the old scroll, truth a murderer would not recognise, but wary to ply us with winsome lies and play a deferential role. No, we were not so wise, more blind than wise, searching for a king for someone else, but at least searching, and finding in someone else's king our end, the end of lifeless ways, the rule for all our days. Later they fancied us kings. In that there was only this truth: he who would wear a crown must first bow low, must first bow down.
A Christmas prayer. Gracious God, as we journey through our lives, strengthen us for the road ahead. May your wisdom be our guide. Give us discerning hearts and protect us from deceit. Lead us into all truth and help us to find peace in humility. May we know the joy of knowing Christ this Christmas and in all the days to come. Amen.
Yeah. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
To help focus our prayers over this season, we have invited each household in Dayspring to use an Advent candle. As many days as we can find time, we take opportunity while the candle burns to hold someone or a group we care about in God's light, the true light that gives light to everybody, God's Son, Jesus. Families with younger children have been keeping a record each day on an Advent prayer calendar. Even the little ones have been able to add bright colours to the outlines on the board, wanting those they pray for to be glad, not sad. As we light a candle today, you may wish to hold somebody in the light of Jesus for just a few seconds. Add words if they come easily to mind, or you can hold them before God in silence. Both count. And so, loving God, Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, we hold friends, family, and those we know may not know but are concerned for in your light.
Did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb?
As we come to the end of this carol service, at the end of this most unusual year, we're going to pray for God's blessing. You may wish to hold your hands out in front of you as we do so to receive God's love and his presence. May the happiness of the angels and the amazement of the shepherds, may the focus of the wise men and the faith of Mary and Joseph, may the presence of the Christ child be with you. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you wherever you are. Amen.